Senator Chris Coons is here, and hopefully Joe and Becky can jump into this conversation as well. I don't know if you had an opportunity to hear what Joe was saying in terms of the way he was sort of positioning the Democratic approach or view of what's happening in these China negotiations. What is your view?
Well, let me give you another analogy that's relevant and recent. North Korea. President Trump sort of escalated the rhetoric with North Korea and threatened and threatened and threatened. We did months and months of saber rattling to the point where the markets and most of our allies around the world were very concerned. We were literally about to go to war with North Korea. Then de-escalates by having what was literally a handshake photo op summit in Singapore that produced nothing of substance. Returned remains of some Americans killed in the Korean War. Some announcements about what they're going to do, but virtually nothing of substance in terms of denuclearization on the Korean Peninsula. The point that
the president says there would be a war with North Korea if it was not for him.
That's great. The State of the Union was, as it often is, full of some puffery, some broad declarations, not a lot of specifics. And on that particular point, I don't know how one could know that. I far prefer a President Trump trying to negotiate with our allies and engage China and contain North Korea to a President Trump who is daily threatening to start a nuclear war.
Speak to what you think the Democrats actually want in terms of tariffs.
Right.
And what success would look like in your mind?
So first, I do think the president is right to step up to China's unfair trade practices. We let them into the WTO. We expected that they would begin to play by the rules as they modernized and opened. That hasn't been the case. But the way he went into this was not just to slap tariffs on Chinese goods, but to start by slapping national security-based tariffs on some of our closest allies, like Canada, Germany, the United Kingdom. And if we're going to have a successful trade fight with China, we need our allies in the mix with us, and we need a clear plan for an exit strategy. I don't think the Trump administration has had either. So I would hate to have this expensive, difficult, unsettling trade fight resolved with just another handshake summit without making structural changes. The president got it right in the State of the Union when he said there need to be structural changes to U.S.-China trade and how China engages with the world economically for us to renormalize relations.
Joe wants to get in here, but what I can't understand is, are you rooting for his failure in these talks?
No, I'm rooting for, I want the United States to succeed, which means I want him to succeed, but I don't want him to withdraw from the field without getting significant concessions.
Okay, Joe?
Senator, you remember the missiles going over Japan like every couple of months and the worry that they could break up over Japan and fall on a civilized...
Joe, the president has accomplished stability with North Korea.
With a straight face, you're saying his position and whatever we've done with North Korea is worse than where we were before. Do you know what's going on right now in terms of where South Korea is in negotiations and China? Do you know how this is going to pan out? You know it's going to be unsuccessful. You don't think it helps that we're at least talking, smiling at each other, shaking hands, arranging new meet? You're criticizing Trump for what's happened with North Korea. Did I get that right?
Joe, no, you got it exactly wrong. I was trying to compliment the president.
You got it exactly wrong.
I was trying to compliment the president for getting us to a place of stasis, but was saying that the very broad goals of his summit with Kim Jong-un in Singapore have so far not come to pass. Of course, I think it is better that we don't have nuclear tests and missile tests, but I was pointing out that he may have withdrawn from the field without having secured all of the concessions from North Korea that he was hoping for. And so I was looking for, and I had hoped to deliver here, an analogy to the tariff talks when you were saying, you know, the left is criticizing, he can't win. I do want the president to succeed because I want our country to succeed. But I hear from farmers and chemical companies in Delaware who say that these tariffs are really affecting their bottom line. I understand the pressure on the president to get off the field and to stop this tariff war. My concern is that we do it without getting real accomplishments out the other end.